Today, when you buy a car, it comes with a key that you don't have to press for the car to open. You simply approach your car, and your car figures out that you are close or that the key is in your pocket, and it will just open for you. It's a wonderful thing to have, but it comes with certain risks. How does the car know that the key is close? We looked into this problem about 7 years ago, and we figured out we can defeat these kind of systems, went on, and essentially taught ourselves how to steal cars by relaying signals between the key and the car. We tested all possible models on the market, and this is still one of the preferred ways for thieves today to steal cars. There are many newspaper reports on how to do this, and this shows one of the images of this happening in action. So I can't show the video for lack of time, but these attacks are actually happening. Someone excites your key and steals your car. In order to protect against these kind of attacks, we need something called secure distance measurement, meaning we need a secure way for systems to determine their mutual distance. This is not only restricted to cars. We need this in many different settings, access to data, payment systems, and different kinds of access to buildings, so physical access to property. But also in the IoT space, the ability to know where objects are is important for objects themselves. Like if you have flying drones, they need to know where they are and where they are with respect to each other. So you need a secure way to position objects and to measure their relative distances. Surprisingly, we don't have that today. So systems like GPS or Wi-Fi or cellular networks are spoofable, meaning that an attacker, by injecting a wireless signal, can change the location of the device. So he can change the measured location of the device. So this location will be different from the true location of the device. So in order to fix this, we decided to improve on these systems and to build an entirely new system at ETH Zurich, to build an entirely new secure positioning system. And what we did during this journey, which lasts now over 10 years, is we actually built an entirely new radio, which is low power, probably secure, of course, very precise and fast. And we are hoping that it's going to replace even connectivity technologies like Bluetooth by providing distance and communication abilities. How does it work? My only technical slide. It works by using round-trip time of flight with very narrow 1 to 2 nanosecond wide ultra-wideband pulses that are then used to achieve such precision that we want. But on top of that, we needed to come up with very clever cryptographic algorithms that would protect the security of this system. And this is shown on this graph, at least in the background. We went even further. In order to push this technology to the community, we are actually standardizing it now. We started a new standard for secure distance measurement, and we got all the key players involved, including Apple, Samsung, Broadcom, and so forth, right? And by pushing the entire community in this direction, we can achieve our long-term goal, which is to deploy a terrestrial secure positioning system that would enable every object to obtain their location securely and for everyone to verify locations of other objects in the environment. However, using radio to determine locations and to determine proximity comes with some additional benefits. So you can do things better than we used to today. So in the scenario of humanitarian airdrops, you could say something like, whoever's in an affected area will get some help. And that you can achieve if you could securely verify locations. Radio is not the only sensing modality that we can use. We can use, for example, sound as well in many different contexts to establish proximity. This is an example where we use sound as a second factor for authentication, meaning that we measure the sound that is in the environment on the phone and on the PC in order to determine that the phone is close to the PC. And if the phone is close, you will be logged in. If the phone is not close, your login will fail. And now you can generalize this to a number of IoT devices that are in your environment and allow seamless, non-interactive online authentication. And maybe to close all this to a maybe more high-level message, internet is all about virtual resources. The goal of my research is to de-virtualize the internet. We want to get physical again, to know where objects are, where the information is coming from, and this will secure existing systems and also enable the deployment of new future systems. So thank you.